He was home alone. Went to sleep, woke up in the early morning hours. Whether right or wrong, he was lonely. So he made a couple of phone calls and arranged he was going to have a female come over and keep him company. In the early morning hours, now we're into July the 4th, the actual holiday. And he called a friend of his, named Curtis Killebrew, to go and pick up his female friend. Actually, he thought one female was coming that he had met and that he liked. But actually, when Curtis Killebrew came, had somebody bring him to Travis's house, and Curtis brought his laundry with him. Curtis is an old friend. They've known each other for a long time, ever since early days. Curtis brought his laundry with him. Somebody dropped him off. He took Travis's station wagon, and he drives over to Oak Road to pick up this female. He goes to the Mapco station there near Gate 1. So you don't want to remember where that is. And when he gets there, a red Toyota pickup truck pulls in. And this girl gets out of it. It's not the same girl that Travis thought was coming to his house. It's another girl. Her name is Brandy Cooper. So she gets in the car with Curtis in the station wagon, and Curtis brings her back for Travis's house. And she's texting on the way back. They get back to Travis's house. Travis and Brandy go in the bedroom. Curtis is doing his laundry. Later, Travis and Brandy come out of the bedroom. Travis takes a shower. And what's Brandy doing? She's texting. Well, who's she texting? You'll find out, ladies and gentlemen, she's texting the people in the red truck. And she's telling, she's sending them text messages telling them how to get to Travis's house. And when they get there, they want to know which door to come to. These are the four occupants of the red truck after Brandy Cooper got out of the red truck at the Mapco station. You have William Miles. Well, I'm sorry, I'm wrong about that. These are the four people who were involved in the home invasion. I misspoke, excuse me. Brandy Cooper was already in the house. William Miles was in the truck. Michael Forrester was driving the truck, and Jekyll Ford was in the truck. Also in the truck was Kendra Lee. But we will show you, ladies and gentlemen, she wasn't just an innocent occupant of the truck either, even though she may not have entered the house. So, we're back at Travis's house, early morning of July the 4th, somewhere around 2 o'clock-ish, 2:30, 3 o'clock. Travis is taking a shower, Brandy Cooper's texting, giving them directions. They pull up in the, well, they're having trouble finding the place. Finally, I think Mr. Forrester said he even missed the turn, turned around, came back, or something like that. Then they get in the driveway, and one of them sends a text, which don't. Well, before that, she's even texting them about maybe Travis being alone But she's trying to get Curtis Gillibrew to leave on, ostensibly on some mission to go pick up another female, which we believe is just a ploy to get him out of the house. And she texted him, that guy's going to be leaving. And I'm going to apologize to you all in advance, because I'm going to use some language that these folks use that is not very pleasant. I want to come out in the trial, and I want you to know what was said. So she's telling them she's trying to get Curtis out of the house. And tells them that he's going to be leaving. She's trying to get him to go pick up a female somewhere. But he's not buying it. He's not going. Curtis is doing his laundry. That's what he wanted to do. So they get in the driveway, and they text her, which door? And she says, front. Kind of cold language. They do F's for front, stuff like that. You'll see the text messages. And then she tells them, well, just make some noise and somebody will open. And you know what she also tells them? Make it look like I'm kidnapped. She wants to make it look like a kidnapped on herself.